I'm here. Took me a little nappity nap. And now your girl gonna figure out the bus to get to the final destination. It's a little cloudy. The sun looked like it was popping out for a hot second, but it's not raining. So I'm good with that. I'll check in with you guys once I figure it out. I love traveling in Europe. They make things so easy here. On the bus, you just tap your card on there and pay. They have the screens up there that tells you where to go. They even have a little map of the ceiling. So cute. Look at that. You're so cute. The weather doesn't look that great today. Hopefully it's there up. Literally, you walk out the airport and get the bus stops until black folks won't get on it. I love traveling in Europe. They make it so easy. Of course, taxi drivers are out there too. Yep, yeah, it's a metro/public transportation person. Walking on to my girl's house, got off the bus. One thing I will do is I will get on public transportation in Europe with no problem. I ain't doing no taxis unless I have to. So, we're gonna walk on the traces. It's not as cold, but I'm glad I brought my jacket. And I'm glad that the rain stopped right when I needed to get out and walk. So, I need my GPS, so I gotta get off this phone right quick. Okay, y'all, look what a nice little neighborhood. So I'm almost there to my girls. If y'all hear the GPS, y'all know how I am. I do stuff the real way, not the pretend way. So, oh, we got the canal here. So here we go. We got the canal and bikes be out. And let's see, I'm almost there to Tracy's house. And there's the canal. When I tell y'all, I got a bag on one arm, bag on the other arm, umbrella underneath the elbow, camera, but it is colder than Nice, but as you can see, my breath, but I'm glad I brought my winter jacket. It does look like the sun's trying to come out, so I'm extremely happy. Hopefully that will be it. That'll be great. As long as it don't mess up my tulip day, it can rain, I don't care. I got my umbrella, I got my umbrella cap, and I'll be good to go. Just not during the tulip day, so I will check in with you all later once I get to my final destination. Hey y'all, I'm here with my girl Trace. Say hey Trace. We gonna give you her handle later, and so I'm getting ready. We've been chit chatting. Okay, we open, so I'm getting ready to go get me a nice sandwich because the girl just need to eat what she know right now, and then we gonna do the experimentation on the Amsterdam food later on. So, y'all, I'm getting me a real pastrami sandwich. Oh my God, look at that, pickles, mustard, pastrami, and marble bread.
Yes,
with a beer. Y'all, look how insane this is. Hail. We are sitting here. It went from raining, then it stopped. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Hail. Look at that. Really? And then it says the sun gonna come out at 8:45. Look, it's coming down even more. Look at this shit. Yeah, their weather here is not Tracy and I were just talking. It ain't bipolar. Theirs is schizophrenic. Look at this. Folks be like, okay. She's like, okay, I got an umbrella. I'm good. What the hell? Are you kidding me? Really? No way. Wow. Schizophrenia at its finest. Now it's totally stopped. Look. Look. Not even drizzling. It is nothing. It just stopped. This is insane. Look at the ice on the street. It just stopped. Look at that. Yeah. Give me my son. I'll come visit. But yeah, I need my sunny sun sun. This is insane. Y'all know I want to learn cheese and I want to teach a cheese class, but when I tell you the cheese up in here is so good, so I found two cheeses they said I could bring back. The red cheese, with the one that I got from that trade show, if y'all saw me that time I was with Marsha, and the guy couldn't tell me where it was, and that truffle chorizo, oh my God, cow truffle. Why is a bitch gonna spend all her money on cheese? I'm about to taste this one. I found another one. Cow truffle.
I'm telling you, they're known.
Oh my God. Oh my God. I'm going to be spending about $100 on cheese. Oh, I'm coming back then. Uh oh.
It's literally right down the street.
Okay, good. I'm coming back. Good morning, y'all. With all the crazy weather Amsterdam was having yesterday, y'all would not believe the weather. Like, it was raining, then it stopped, then it was hail, like a literal hailstorm, then it stopped, then the sun came out for a little bit, then it started raining again. It was the most erratic weather. Today, I'm going to the tulip fields, and so I'm so glad that it is sunny, it's nippy, but I don't give a damn. As long as it's sunny, while I'm out there with the tulip fields, because that's the main reason I came to Amsterdam. So it's beautiful. It's just really, really gorgeous. So I'm walking to the meeting point. I'm a big get your guide gal, so I do look up their tours and I've been using them for years. But just look, it's early, it's quiet. There's the canals that run through Amsterdam, right through the neighborhoods. You gotta be careful of crazies like that, though. These people over here apparently have a lot more rights than drivers when it comes to bikes. And there are more bikes than people. Look at that. In Amsterdam. And it is definitely a mode of transportation for them. So so yeah, so you gotta really be careful, because when I tell you, they're like, we will run your ass over. They're like, we will run your ass over. So take a few little shots, because your girl gotta hump it. It says a half an hour and I'm thinking it was like 15 minutes and I gotta be there at a certain time. So I'm gonna check back in with y'all once I get to the meeting point. When I tell you, I'm so multitasking right now. So I got about maybe 6 more minutes to walk to get to the meeting point. But look, I mean, it's not that cold. Look how pretty that is. So, your girl hot. This, I love this coat. Glad I got it. Check. They are. take the ferry to the other side. So I'm on the bus. That was out. I am sweating. I'm on the bus, and so I'm gonna go to the tulip fields, a tulip tour, and take the boat tour with the windmills. A very nice bus. Quiet, clean. So so they tell you to get there 15 minutes at a time, but you probably really need to get there an hour ahead of time because they still make you stand in line and you have to check in even though you have your ticket through the app. So get your guide. You need to get better on this one and tell people to be there an hour ahead of time. So yeah, but anyway, I'm going to chill for the ride and let's see some sights. Little tulip farmer tour, so we're going to learn about tulips first before we get to the real garden. And you can see some tulips over there. But this is not the ultimate
weekend
stop.
Sold out for the weekend, I think every day, almost sold out, 60,000 people.
Wow.
And everybody makes pictures of me, I see.
No, not no. Yet. You want me to? There.
Smile, you're kidding. Combination of flower bulbs to grow, especially for the hyacinths. The groundwater is also very high here. It's only 65 centimeters below us, like this. That is high.
Okay, we are in the tulip fields. Look how gorgeous it is. This is just the farm. We just had a quick little tour, but we're going to the real one after this. But it's just so pretty. Everyone's taking pictures, of course. But yeah, he was explaining how the tulip fields, how the tulips, that's the farmer right there. And he was explaining.
Here we are. This is
where we are, tons of damn people. I'm not sure about this. I got my ticket, so we shall see.
75
euros. Okay, so we're in the supposed tulip garden. So let me tell y'all about this tulip garden. Okay, and this is supposedly the one that it supposedly is the one that everybody comes to, the most popular.
Yes.
Okay. That's this. It is a tulip garden. Do not get it twisted. It is not a tulip field. It is not. It is a big ass garden. Yeah. It's a big ass garden and it's not worth coming to. It's not the fields like you think where you'll be in the fields of the tulips. It is absolutely not that. Don't fall for it. Find an actual field. Make sure you read to know that you are going to tulip fields and not to a tulip garden. I could have went to the store and just a flower shop and looked at all of these. So don't do it. Now don't get me wrong. The flowers are gorgeous, but absolutely not the experience that I was looking for, and I'm very disappointed. And all the food stations here stink. The food is horrible. It is definitely a big-ass tourist trap. Huge tourist trap. Lots of people. It's just, I would not recommend it at all. And it's just amazing the Instagrammer people that are out here trying to do these bullshit pictures. It's crazy. It's just absolutely nuts. And now it's boat time, and it's packed, so I don't know if we'll be able to have a seat. But the problem is a seat. Okay, now after that horrible boat ride and that tulip excursion, we're going to do the Heineken excursion. And this was a pretty cool tour. It's like an hour and a half, and you can do a regular tour, which is 20-something euros, or you can do a private VIP tour, which is 60-something euros, which I think is worth it anyway. So it gives you the history of Heineken and who started it and how they do the barley and the hops and the yeast and all that good jigga-ma-jigga stuff. I've been drinking Heineken since I was little because when my daddy would tell me to go get him a Heineken, I would always take me a little sip. So yeah, and then they showed us these thingamajiggas, I don't know what they are, but it showed that's where they put them in, brewed them, how it came out afterwards, and you know, to get what we all like to drink nowadays, which is Heineken. And so then after we left here, they had a cool little spot. One thing I love about this tour is you get two little tickets to get two beers, but really you get three beers. I would suggest that you have a little meal before you go because you might be a little tipsy by the time you leave there if you're not a beer drinker, because I sure had my three.
This is a pretty good camera to make movies on.
Y'all, when I tell you this drink, this is a porn star. This one, oh my God, and it's got the passion. Look, I got, no, let me take y'all's.
Oh my God.
I take a sip first before I show you. And then this is the bitterballing. And then we have a mushroom skewer. And they gave me a little Prosecco on the side. It ain't even up in here. And then Tracy got, now she gonna be on her ass. I can't do this. She got gin with what? With
basil smack.
Mm. It may look little, but she's, that ain't nothing but gin and just a piece of basil dropped in it. Look, and we ain't even at dinner yet. This is just the before dinner. So I'm going to check y'all because this drink is lovely. I'm about to crawl up in it. Okay, we're taking a late night walk. seen some interesting things on our way home after having fries. And here's the palace. Why are all these buildings having construction done on them? Like, what's going on? But here's, what is this? Is this the city center?
Yeah.
So this is the city center. Yes, we hanging because it is after 1 o'clock, but we both gonna sleep real good, I guarantee you.
Accepting.